Penelope Cruz, we have the record nominations for Mexico here tonight, which is a huge, huge thing. Thank you so much. Oh boy, what a night. So here we go. This is very exciting. And as you saw just now in that film by Academy Award-winning director Errol Morris, tonight we're celebrating the nominees, as opposed to all the other years when we pretty much just celebrated the winners. Tonight, we're going to celebrate you because you're nominated. Just because you're nominated, we're going to celebrate you. I wish there was a way for me to convey how much I want to celebrate you. A tambourine in my hand. What's this? I would not want to follow that. There's really, I try to figure it out. There's no rhyme or reason to who's going to win, how they figure these things out, because, you know, you can't. Jennifer Hudson here tonight, and look at that. I tell you, Jennifer Hudson was on American Idol. America didn't vote for her, and yet she's here with an Oscar nomination. That's amazing. That's incredible. You know? And then Al Gore is here. America did vote for him, and then it's...
Good evening. The first Oscar tonight is for art direction. The art director...
It's always about the sink.
Best Supporting Actor.
So this is me jumping around on Oscar morning.
He said, come on out. I was ready to leave, and of course my wife wanted me to stick around and finish the honeymoon.
Always better the second time around.
Every time you go to a movie, it's a blind date.
We're nominated for picture, director, things like that.
Set decorators are asked to create an entire world to which the audience can run away to for a few hours. This year, the nominated films took place in the fantasy worlds of Pirates of the Caribbean and Pan's Labyrinth, in the secret world of the magician in The Prestige.
And in The Good Shepherd and Dreamgirls, the mutually exclusive worlds of white America and black America in the 50s and the 60s. We were there, thanks to the extraordinary work of these nominees for Best Art Direction.